An author of a bill seeking to create the controversial Maharlika investment fund admits he's having second thoughts about it. Sharon Torres reports.
Philippine senators are still unconvinced the country needs its very own sovereign wealth fund. During Wednesday's second hearing for the creation of the Maharlika Investment Fund, senators cite several reasons why the proposed bills cannot be accepted in their current form. Among the reasons cited are issues on the source of funding, how the money will be invested, and the failure of proponents to present documents being asked by the senators. Senate Minority Leader Aquilino Pimentel III calls the bills disappointing.
We observe the majority aligned with the admin, and we see what you're doing. You're conducting a very expensive public brainstorming. Being an administration measure, the Senate should not allow this to pass in its current form.
And it's not just senators. A good governance advocacy group also raised reservations over plans to use funds from the Land Bank of the Philippines and Development Bank of the Philippines to finance the MIF. Foundation for Economic Freedom President Calixto Chiquiamco points out the proposed bills have no clear provisions on whether or not government will guarantee the LBP and DPP funds.
If it is not guaranteed, it increases systemic risks to the banking system. Devaluation of the value of the MIF will translate to losses to the DBP and Land Bank. So, maaari ito magkasunog sa buong financial system.
Chiquiamco recommends privatizing government assets instead of tapping state-owned financial institutions, like Land Bank, which is meant to aid the agriculture sector through loans.
The MIF will likely produce intergenerational debt rather than intergenerational wealth. An even playing field will dampen rather than improve the investment climate.
But the Land Bank chief argues they have a stable financial position and can even provide a 50 billion peso budget for MIF. Land Bank says it has 1.3 trillion peso investable funds. The bank's president, Cecilia Borromeo, however, admits they have yet to see a business plan on how the wealth fund will be used.
Unlucky ho, no? I'm not happy to hear that there's this much funds in a bank, considering that the GFIs are geared towards a specific mandate, no? Land Bank for agriculture, DBP for developmental projects. Have you seen the business plan?
Of the corporation for not yet, sir.
Maharlika Investment Fund?
No, none.
So you haven't seen the business
plan?
And
so we don't have any rating and the investment because of lack of historical information.
In the meantime, Senator Rafi Tulfo, who also filed a bill creating a sovereign wealth fund, admits he's having second thoughts.
Pinag-aralan ko pa rin po kung ano ba talaga maging stand ko sa Maharlika Fund. Kung ito ba'y makakabuti sa taong bayan. At kapag nakita ko na hindi, then I will not vote for it.
The Senate Banks panel will continue hearing the MIF bills within the month. Shabian Torres, ABS-CBN News.
Philippine Senator Grace Ho flags an alleged human trafficking attempt at the Ninoy Aquino International Airport. Ho said it's in connection with a flight that was supposed to leave for Dubai Monday. According to Ho, only 6 passengers of that plane were declared, but a total of 14 would actually be included in the flight. Ho questioned the Bureau of Immigration for allowing the plane to depart, even if it did not undergo pre-flight inspection.
These individuals were not included in the general declaration, but they attempted to board the aircraft. However, at around the same time, the inspectors noticed 3 unauthorized individuals entering the aircraft, followed by the aircraft door closing. More than just a protocol glitch, the issue digs deeper as it involves national security and human trafficking. We call on the Bureau of Immigration to explain how individuals were able to fly out of the country with just a whim of uttered clearance from an immigration officer without an amendment of the general declaration based on proper procedures.
The Senate Blue Ribbon Committee is set to investigate the Global Aviation Service Corporation, the alleged handler of the Christian aircraft. It was also allegedly linked to the attempted escape of formerly officials who were involved in the government's allegedly anomalous pandemic supply deals. Money sent home by Filipinos overseas reached a new record high. The Philippine Central Bank says personal remittances soared to $3.49 billion in December last year. That's a year-on-year increase of 5.7%. That brought the total in 2022 to hit an all-time high as well at $36.14 billion. The cash remittances forced through banks also increased by 5.8% in January compared to the same month in 2021. The U.S. registered the highest share of overall remittances at 41%.
Philippine transport groups oppose a plan to open 100,000 transport network vehicle service slots. The group Laban TNVS says the move will adversely affect the livelihood of small TNVS operators. It adds it may also reduce the income of operators and drivers of taxis, jeepneys, and tricycles. For Manibela, government should instead focus on improving the public transport system. Transport authorities earlier said they will allow 100,000 vehicles to be registered as TNVS under Grab Philippines. This after the company vowed to President Marcos that it will make an investment to create 500,000 jobs.